Hello, good evening, Chuckadelphia. This is Chuck coming to you from the Command Center. And tonight I wanted to talk to you a little bit about conditionals. This is part three of my conditional review series. And tonight we're going to be focusing on mixed conditionals and conditionals with progressive forms, okay? So sit back, relax, and come along with me for the ride. Here we go, okay? So the first thing is this. We can commonly mix conditionals to show a relationship between the present and the past, okay? And many times we can mix the second and third conditional structures, okay? So I want you to see this example. I am late now for class because I was stuck in traffic. Notice how a past action affects a current action or state, right? So now see what the cause is in the because clause. I was stuck in traffic, right? That will be your if clause. There, you pay attention to the verb tense, right? So we have the simple past here. Okay, so in the simple past, in the cause clause, this is going to become the third conditional structure. Okay, and this is the simple present. Okay, and this will become the second conditional result clause. Okay, so I was stuck in traffic becomes I had not been stuck in traffic, because remember, we're going to change the positive to the negative, right, and the simple past to the past perfect. So this is your if clause. If I had not been stuck in traffic. I am late for class. This is right now. Since we are dealing with a hypothetical result in the present, we will use the second conditional clause and make it a negative too. I would not be late for class. Okay, so this is how your conditional will look. If I had not been stuck in traffic, I would not be late for class. You see? It's not too hard, all right? Now, the same can be applied for a current condition and how it relates to the past, okay? See this, I could not reach the top of the tree because I do not have a ladder, right? So let us apply the same rules that we did a moment ago, but let's pay attention to the verb tenses again. So here in the cause clause, I do not have a ladder. There's your negative and there's a simple present, okay? So in the conditional, we're going to get rid of this negative and use the simple past, right? In the because clause, it would look like this in the conditional. If I had a ladder, right? Because, right? So now the result clause is this, okay? I could not reach the top of the tree. That will become, I could have reached the top of the tree. You understand? So our mixed conditional would be, if I had a ladder, I could have reached the top of the tree. So notice how not gets out of there, right? No, not, we remove the negative, and we're using the third conditional result clause because this is in the past. Could have reached the top of the tree. Okay, that's not too hard, right? No, I don't think so. I think you'll be okay. So let's try some more, okay? I am unemployed, so I could not afford to pay for dinner last night. Okay, this is our cause and this is the effect. The cause is now and this is the effect for last night. So see here, we got to make this into the second conditional in the cause, and this is the past, right? Last night. So we're going to make this into the result clause in our conditional. So this will become the second conditional, were, and then we would say employed, right? Because that's the opposite. Or we could use a negative. But here we're going to say, if I were employed, right? And then this, okay, get rid of the not, and then use the third conditional result clause for last night. I could have afforded to pay for dinner last night. You see? Okay, so this is how the conditional would look. If I were employed, I could have afforded to pay for dinner last night. And as you know, we can also switch the structure around and say, I could have afforded to pay for dinner last night if I were employed, all right? So here's another one. I saw that movie in the theaters, so I do not want to watch it on TV now, okay? Here's the cause, and that's in the simple past, right? So our conditional is going to change into the past perfect, and see, here's a positive. So the past perfect will be negative in the conditional, and that will see, that will be, if I had not seen that movie in the theaters, right? There's your conditional clause, and here's the effect, right? So this is the present and the negative. So we get rid of the negative, right? Get rid of do. And now we're going to use the second conditional would here, or could, as you know. So this would look like this. I would want to watch it on TV now. You got it? So the conditional is, if I had not seen that movie in theaters, I would want to watch it now, right? And then we could switch it around to say, I would want to watch the movie now if I had not seen it in the theaters. Okay? Not too bad. I won't go to the beach today because I went there last week. Here's your cause clause. Okay, there's a simple past. All right, so in the conditional is going to become the past perfect. And since this is the positive here, the conditional clause is going to be this. If I had not gone to the beach last week, and now here we have the simple future, and it's in the negative, right? So we're going to get rid of the negative, and we're going to use the second conditional result clause. I would go to the beach today. And the conditional would be this. If I had not gone to the beach last week, I would go to the beach today, right? And there's your comma there. And we could also change the structure around. I would go to the beach today if I had not gone there last week, right? Not too bad at all, not too hard. Now let's throw some progressives in here. We are stuck inside under quarantine, so we are not enjoying the weather outside. Okay, so it's very similar, okay? You see here, here's our effect, and we have a negative. We have a negative, and we also have the progressive here. Okay, so we simply get rid of the negative, and we would change this into the progressive, okay? And here's our conditional clause. If we were not stuck inside under quarantine, we, second conditional, and then we'll use the progressive here, would be enjoying the weather outside, okay? So our conditional looks like this. If we were not stuck inside under quarantine, we would be enjoying the weather outside. And we can also switch the order around. We would be enjoying the weather outside if we were not stuck inside under quarantine. Okay? So the thing is, you really have to remember your verb tenses, okay? Your past perfects for the third conditional clause, right? You have to remember your progressive rule. You got to remember your simple past rules, okay? Subject verb agreement rules, okay? And that will help your conditionals become a lot easier, all right? So here, I was taking a shower. I did not hear the phone when you called, okay? So we have the past progressive, that's the cause. So that's going to be our conditional. And see, the progressive, the past progressive, becomes the past perfect progressive, and we're going to use a negative here. If I hadn't been taking a shower, okay, this will be our third conditional result clause because we have the simple past here. I did not hear the phone when you called. So this would become, I would have heard the phone when you called, because here we have the negative, we get rid of that, and then we use the third conditional result clause, would have heard, right? So the conditional will look like this. If I hadn't been taking a shower, I would have heard the phone when you called, right? And also, we can flip it around and say, I would have heard the phone when you called if I hadn't been taking a shower, right? Not too bad. I'm not swimming in the lake because it is cold, okay? So here's your cause, right? And we would use simple past here. And since this is positive, it would become negative, right? If it weren't cold outside, and we have the progressive now, okay? So let's use the second conditional result clause with a conditional, okay? I would be swimming in the lake, right? Because this would be, that's the second conditional result clause, and then swimming because it's active right now at this very moment, okay? So we would say, if it weren't cold outside, I would be swimming in the lake, right? And also, I would be swimming in the lake if it weren't cold outside. Not too bad, not too hard at all, right? So there you go. That is my summary of mixed conditionals as well as the progressives in conditional clauses, conditional structures, okay? It's not too hard, it just takes a lot of practice. And the reason that you guys need to know your conditional structures is because conditionals are heavily used in English. It's a great way to get to know someone, especially when we talk about the hypothetical situations. What would you do if? What would you do if you won the lottery? What would you do if you saw a coworker doing something bad? What would you do if your best friend committed something illegal, right? These are all ways that we get to know each other. And it's good structure that you may hear at job interviews or like when you're just hanging out with friends, okay? So that's all for tonight. Carpe diem, everybody. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you, Scott Cassidy, again, for this lovely picture of Australia, the Australian night. I appreciate you guys watching. I hope you are safe. I hope you continue to be safe. And in my heart, I hope this quarantine, this lockdown, whatever you want to call it, is just a little bit longer and we can get back to life as we know it. Okay, so thank you for watching Chuckadelphia. I appreciate it. Have a wonderful night. As always, carpe diem and ciao, ciao.